Howdy. Welcome back. Today, we are going to go do Primrose's story because last time we finished Ophelia. But, as you can see, she needs to be level 45. And it needs to be level 38. She is not. Primrose needs to be level 40. She is level 42. Let us finally get this story that has been waiting so long to get started. Get started. Oh, did I come? I think I came here at one point. And I think I came here at one point for something or another and said not start the story yet. I cannot remember what I did. I think I did that. Here it tell. Hearing the words of the dying crow, you have come home to Novacorp, where you hope to find the truth that has eluded you for so long. I guess I actually came here at one point and forgot.
Oh well.
How did we get all the way over here? The story so far. In the town of Steel Snow, Primrose got a hopeless taste of it. Revenge, then she struck down the left wing of the crow, dragging the dagger and great family's words into her breast. Fate shall be your share. The words have served her well. Now, two remain. The mare with the moth on his right arm, and the phallus for the law with the moth on his neck. Go home to Novacorp, she was told. There you'll find the truth you seek. There will be peace for the pain after many years we return home.
Oh my.
Long enough, you were a kid when it happened. Maybe our father was a crow. If it is that, I'm done. That's gonna be the stupidest thing. Everybody already realizes me?
No.
Okay. What's going on during the present? Ah, somebody's dead, of course. Fine, should that this is Christmas starting to take off.
Just so.
Your father died, the watch has fallen apart, and now he's... no.
Gah.
AKA, I'm pretty sure that their lord is one of the... freaking crow people. You're one of the people who used to be on the watch, aren't you?
Hey.
A trusted friend. Ravello Forsythe. If we talk to him about what happened... well, no. Knew it. Get out of my house. Get out of my house!
Oh. Oh.
Yeah, boy, we're gonna have to fight that guy. I knew it.
Could it be?
Well, if you were not kidding, Indo. Your boyfriend?
Primrose.
Simeon.
Simeon.
Simeon. Okay, Simeon.
Of course.
Just come here.
Primrose.
You've been a dancer, you killed.
Yeah, I mean, you could tell you had to do some stuff.
I'm sorry.
Simeon's gentle words just Primrose, a feeling she had not felt many years. For the first time in what seemed like forever, she felt somewhere deep in her heart a measure of peace.
Mm-hmm.
Crap, gods!
Seeing you again, it brings back so many memories. Memories of my childhood days in this town.
Yay, flashback!
I could never understand why my father was so strict with me. I was always running off to the gardens for a good cry.
And that was where I would find you. And find an excuse to shirk my duties as gardener's apprentice. I wanted nothing more than to spend time with you. To be a part of your world.
Just to be a part of your world.
Little lady. Why do you cry so?
What? We couldn't help but be drawn to one another. Like the bees, drawn to the nectar of the fragrant blooms. You were always penning poems for me. Your words, your songs, gave me comfort and solace. In the darkest days after I lost father, you would sing them for me over and over.
To tell the truth, Primrose, I left this town to search for you. to accept that you are gone? Yet time and again, I found myself reciting the poems I had written you. Can you forgive me, Primrose?
There is nothing to forgive. It was all so very long ago. I, too, have moved on from those days. I have found my own reason to go on.
And when the moon waxes full and bright in dark heaven, and stars glitter worlds away from earthly sorrow, would that sleep hold you in her soft embrace? Then shall my eyes close, lips open in prayer, for it is only in dreams that we may meet again.
He's gonna die. And that's gonna make us mad.
Lady Primrose, I intend to remain in town for some time yet. I still have not forgiven myself. Knowing that I could not do more for you, it tortures me to this day. If there is any way at all, in which I can be of service to you, my lady, you need only say the word.
Thank you, Simeon. Enough distractions. I must find the men marked by the crow. But where to begin?
Your house. I mean, where else would you go? Travel banter. Dot dot dot. So this is where
this
you
is
in the playgrounds where she spent most of her days. Where she's changed in the last 10 years. It seems like this.
Farewell. What? How could this? Lady Primrose? The gods. I'm sorry.
actually killed
actually
the person who took her in as a dancer because he killed her best friend. And yeah. Story, tell us. Are you Primrose?
I know what I must do.
I know what I must do now. It's my life, one and only. Da 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 da. Da 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 da.
It's not possible.
Yeah, it is.
Then Rose?
Well, Primrose is about to go kill somebody.
Faith shall be your shield.
That one phrase.
Hmm. Now then. Lady Primrose.
Okay, this gives us our time to go your travel ban to another set. Okay, in the next episode, we will head toward the obsidian sea. Meanwhile, Barry will be playing this dog.
I'll see you guys in the next episode.